Hello, friends. God bless you. Thank you for joining us.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?
Today's subject is Satan's ministers. It's Apostates in the Apostasy, Part 5. Our first passage is 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse number 1. Now, the Holy Spirit tells us clearly that in the last times, some will turn away from the true faith. They will follow deceptive spirits and teachings that come from demons. Second passage, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 3 and 4. For a time is coming when people will no longer listen to sound and wholesome teaching. They will follow their own desires and look for teachers who will tell them whatever their itching ears want to hear. They will reject the truth and chase after myths. Well, there are indeed all kinds of errors, heresies, and false religions in this world. Many deny Christ. Some claim outright that they do not believe in the God of the Bible. They live for this life only and scorn any who believe in eternal life through Christ. While all of those different kinds of teachings are deceptive, dangerous, and have eternal ramifications, it's not what Paul is referring to specifically in the verses that we've read today. These verses reveal what the Holy Spirit says will happen within Christianity, especially during the final days of this age. Satan is an imitator and counterfeiter. He often imitates and counterfeits God. As a result, just as God has his ministers, Satan has his own too. As God's ministers proclaim his doctrines, Satan's ministers proclaim his. Satan's ministers endeavor to confuse God's children and lead them astray. He has no message of his own. He only twists God's message. He's been doing this from the beginning of time. He doesn't create anything new. He distorts the original. That's all it takes. A little yeast will leaven the whole lump of dough. Satan didn't create marriage. He merely changes it from its original intention. He cannot produce love, so he twists it to mean something godless and self-serving. He doesn't originate pleasure. Therefore, he corrupts it to exclude God. He can't offer salvation. Thus, he presents a compromised version of it without the truth. He uses biblical terms but redefines their meaning. Let's not forget the words of the wise early church father. Error rides on the back of truth. Although it may seem strange, Satan's ministers often work right out of the church. Paul plainly warned they would arise from within the church. A lot of Christians think the false prophets are all out there somewhere else and we're safe if we're in a church building. I say, wake up. Satan's ministers often preach his doctrines from the pulpits of churches that bear the name of Christ. That's another possible reason why Jesus said, many will come in my name saying I am the Christ and deceive many. These false teachers will say they believe Jesus is the Christ and then still slip in a false doctrine on you. If they were to deny Christ outright, that wouldn't deceive nearly as many people. Some do that, but what they like to do oftentimes is let their error ride on the back of truth. In fact, many false teachers do not even deny Christ's teachings. They merely twist and distort them. They poison the unsuspecting multitudes by slipping the poison in with some of the truth. Or let me say it like this. They feed the innocent listeners a nice, juicy, poisoned steak. It looks good and it may taste great, but it will kill you. That is why Paul challenged believers in the church to prove all things. Hold fast to that which is good. Read your Bible. Don't be fooled. Don't believe every spirit and every so-called prophet or preacher. As evangelical Christians, let us hold to biblical sound doctrine in our time. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, lead us in the way everlasting, and keep our feet from slipping and our hearts from being deceived. In Jesus' name, amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. Amen.
I know whom I have believed and am persuaded that He is able to keep that which I've committed unto Him against that day.